We're here today at the client's house that Anne is working with. The clients are Mimi and Sal. And I actually had worked with them earlier, and we actually put the design to a halt because they decided that they wanted to move, and they're moving downtown. So Anne, I am so glad they hired you because they have a great collection of artwork. And I know that it takes a lot to figure out which goes where since they do have multiple homes.
Right. And we've started the process already. We're starting to do some tagging of pieces to go to the different homes. And we're going to be doing an actual measurement to make sure that they're all going to fit on the walls that we'd hope for. We have Mimi and Sal right over here. Can they come over and join us?
Yes, they can. Mimi, I know you have this great piece behind you. And I know it took a lot to get it here because it's not just a local piece. It actually had to come across some water.
It did, actually. We saw this piece in Hawaii and fell in love with it in Hawaii. Went back a couple times, drank a little wine, decided he had to come home with us, and he came shipped in a big crate, came across the ocean, and he's been with us for years. The kids have had all of their prom pictures, first communion pictures, graduation pictures. Their friends come here and have pictures taken with the ostrich. When we said we were moving, everyone wrote, "What of the ostrich?" So it's like a signature piece for us.
He's part of the family.
He is part of the family. And we are so grateful to have found Anne because we were so nervous about moving all our art.
Yep.
It was just really putting us in a state of frenzy. And then we were put in contact with her, and it was like everything lifted off our shoulders. We are so happy.
Mm-hmm. We're going to take really good care of him. Personally, I'm going to accompany him on the move to make sure. Yeah, we're going to wrap him and crate him. Not wood crate, but we're going to crate him so he gets there in one piece and make sure. And then all the other art that you've had to make a really tough decision because it all can't fit uptown and it's got to go other places. And so you're starting the process with the tags, the different colored tags on the walls. And how do you choose?
Well, first initially, Mimi took the three different color tags and she put them where we thought we might take them.
Right.
And then we had, when we went actually to look at the place, because we really were not remembering 100% what kind of walls we had up there.
Right.
Because, you know, we got it when we were in South Carolina.
So we realized that probably Anna's going to tell us not everything can go. So,
yeah.
So what we did the other day was we went through each piece and we have an A, a B, and a C list. And we've listed them, columns for Anne, and she knows the thing she absolutely has to figure out getting there.
Yep.
And then we'll work from there. And our daughters are waiting in the wings to have some things that Anne will probably be shipping to them ultimately when we can't decide what else is coming.
Okay. So there's any decisions? I know your house in Denver may be different than the one that you have in South Carolina. Can you maybe tell some decisions that style-wise what you're working towards maybe in Denver to what is already in your Hilton Head home?
I would say contemporary in Denver.
Yeah, and then you know, we try to keep it a beachy kind of feel and in Hilton Head. So there are some of these pieces here that would fit with that. That's how we identified some of that.
Yeah. And South Carolina has that gullah influence. Like our little talking ladies and our beach piece all seem to fit there.
Yeah.
So you've done it by theme and how you feel when you're there. And,
yeah.
And then the other stuff goes up to the mountains.
Yes.
As space and time and more rustic, maybe, or
that's a more mountain type.
More mountain
feeling.
Mm-hmm.
So that's how we're deciding with that. I do want to echo though Mimi's comments about Anne, because when we got back here a week ago Monday, and on Tuesday morning when I got up and I looked at everything, I thought I was going to just cry. I mean, I didn't think that this was possible to do this. And then after our meeting with Anne, I have been enjoying this move ever since. I mean, we've just been having a great time.
And it
ready.
Is so, an exciting move. Cool. I know Mimi and I talked about it, and I'm kind of envious myself because the idea of living downtown just seems so much fun and interesting, especially with the things that you guys like to do. So it needs to be that enjoyable move and not this stress of trying to get this home sold and moving on to the next thing.
Because it does have to be sold, so
it does.
Anything you guys
anything
can do to find a buyer.
And if anybody
wonderful.
Out there wants
wonderful.
To buy it, go to our website and we can make sure we connect you.
We'll have some good pictures of the house itself,
right?
At least the outside.
But we are telling everyone about Anne and her services because, honestly, she has made everything so much fun for us.
Yeah.
And then we'll get there and we'll get it all done, and then we'll raise a glass of something and you'll go, I didn't think we could all do it, but we did.
Well, we do have that wine cabinet downstairs, so.
Okay.
So that'll be coming with you.
That'll be going with you? Okay,
yes.
Well, that's good.
Yeah, we're going to show you where that's going.
Okay, good. And you know where that's going. And is it full?
It's full.
We'll get those containers, those special containers, so we don't kill the wine on the way.
Oh, good. Please. We wanted to check with you.
There's some stuff we've been storing for a while.
Okay, so. Well, we'll make sure that it doesn't get ruined in transit. Okay.
Excellent.
Good deal.
So Mimi and Sal, thank you so much for letting us follow you through this move. I know you're in good hands with Anne, so thank you, Anne. Coming up next, we're going out to the Parade of Homes.